Let's see. Okay. Carry the 2. Had the 1.
Hey, Maccy. What are you working on today?
I'm studying for a math test I have next week. But things aren't adding up. I thought computers are supposed to be good at math.
Well, Maccy, I have the perfect game for you. It's Number Munchers from MECC.
Ooh, but I need to be studying, not playing games.
Number Munchers is studying and playing games, Maccy.
That's possible?
Well, let's pop the disc in and take a look.
Ooh, I like the sound of that.
Number Munchers was created as part of MECC's suite of educational games that were sold and distributed to classrooms all across the United States, primarily aimed at elementary schools and marketed as a grade 3 to adults game. Number Munchers mix Pac-Man arcade-style game mechanics with the addition of a wholesome helping of mathematics.
I will take just a little bit of math, please.
Number Munchers takes place on a 5x6 grid. You take control of a muncher, a little green frog guy, whose only purpose in life is to eat the right answer that matches the prompt at the top of the screen, all while trying to avoid getting eaten by the evil Troggles.
Troggles! How dare they munch my numbers?
Not only do you have to avoid the Troggles, Maccy, but you have to rely on your math skills in order to get the right answer. If you get the wrong answer, you lose a life.
Who knew a kid's game could be so stressful? I have to do math and run from Troggles?
Don't worry too much, Maccy. The game starts off fairly easy depending on which challenge you choose. You can select from 5 different modes of gameplay on the original Apple II version of Number Munchers. There are multiples, factors, primes, equality, and inequality.
Neato Toledo!
The difficulty increases as the levels progress, so you have plenty of time to sharpen your math skills.
I need to work on my primes. Let's see, there's, 3, 5, 7, B?
I don't think B's a number, Maccy.
Oops. Did I say B? I meant 11.
Silly me, slipping into hexadecimal.
Unfortunately, there aren't any hexadecimal numbers in Number Munchers.
So, what about those Troggles? They look scary.
There are several Troggle types, each with their own Looney Tunes-inspired Latin name and their own unique behavior that will keep you on your toes. There's the Reggie, Trogulus Normalis, the common Troggle. As he walks through the game and eats numbers, he changes them as he goes.
I have an uncle named Reggie. He works at Nintendo.
And then there's the Helper, Trogulus Assistus. These are happy-looking jelly bean Troggles that eat the numbers. They can actually help you finish a level faster, since they clear a board and leave nothing behind. But they can take away some of your precious points. And they can eat you.
How are these guys helping? They're taking away my precious points!
And then there's the Worker, Trogulus Laboris. They always try to rebuild the map. Whereas the Helper eats the numbers, the Worker will try to fill in any blank spaces. There's also the Bashful Toggles, Trogulus Timidus.
Wow, they tried really hard with those names.
The Bashful Toggles have a cute little beak, and they usually try to avoid the Muncher. And then we have the Smarties, Trogulus Smarticus. They travel in a sporadic pattern, and once they get close to the Muncher, they hone in and stalk its prey until it eats you.
Don't scare me like that. I think I can do math fast enough to shake off these Troggles.
Let's try playing the game.
Let's get the game loaded up. But first, let's load it up on the Apple IIgs. The Apple II is actually the first release of Number Munchers. Then we can show off the Mac version.
Time for a transfer.
All right, Maccy, now that you're on the 2GS, are you ready to play Number Munchers?
I am. I need to learn my letters so I can ace the math test.
So let's start off on easy mode first, multiples. Here you have to move your muncher around the screen with the arrow keys and press the space bar whenever you want to munch down on the correct answer.
Okay, so multiples of 3. That is 9, 6, 9, 13, 9.
Be careful. Chomp on the wrong number, and you'll end up losing a turn.
Aw, 13 isn't divisible by 3. Closest is 12. I'll remember that for next time.
It's okay, Maccy. It's all part of learning.
Let's keep on playing.
Let's move on to the equality section. Here we have to do some quick math. So the prompt is telling you to choose the right response that matches the number 5.
Oh no, gotta go fast. 5 plus 0 is, 5, that's easy. 10 divided by 2 is 5 again.
You're getting the hang of it, Maccy.
Munchers cartoon.
Every 3 levels, you're treated with a new Muncher vs. Truggle cartoon.
Ooh, I want to see all the cartoons.
Well, to see all the cartoons, you have to help the Muncher eat all the right answers.
Okay, then it's time for more learning.
What about number Munchers for the Mac? I think I'm ready for those sweet black and white graphics again. Back at home.
So, as you can see, Number Munchers on the black and white Mac is, of course, black and white.
Neato Toledo.
The Mac version gives the option to use the mouse to control the Muncher, but otherwise, you get a very similar experience to Number Munchers on the 2GS, minus color, of course.
Cartoons! Are there any in this one?
The cartoons are all there with their black and white rendition.
Oh, yeah! If I keep playing this, I'm sure to ace the math test.
And that's the beauty of Number Munchers. It's an educational game that keeps you learning your arithmetic, all while being fun and increasingly challenging as you improve your math skills. Hey, Maccy, how's it going?
It's going pretty great today, Ms.Fox.
So I was wondering, how did you do on that test the other day?
I did terrific, Ms.Fox. I got a 60!
You got a 60? A 60 out of what, Maccy?
A 60 out of 64.
And all thanks to your game, Miss Fox.
You got a 96 out of 100. That's a good job. You keep slipping into hexadecimal, though, and you scared me. Maybe next time we can go over some other games that will help you in other subjects in school.
You mean there's more games to play for school?
There sure are, Maccy. But we'll have to wait until next time to play them. And I hope you can join us, too. Well, that's all for today's little episode. We hope you enjoyed it.
Goodbye, everyone. See you next time.
Bye.
Bye.